hungry. If I keep my eyes closed, I can't see how small the crowd is.
In recent news, Halsey just welcomed her first child into the world, so it makes sense that during her pregnancy, she upgraded her living situation too. The singer dropped $10.2 million on her new home, a stunning 4.75 acre compound in the mountains between Calabasas and Malibu. She purchased the home off of Liam Payne, and aside from raising her family, Halsey will also have room here to work, as one of the many features on the property include a private recording studio. Today, we're gonna check out where she calls home, and just wait until you see all the amazing extras at the new place. In these videos, we don't reveal any addresses, and even though I've done a house tour of my own place, please do not show up at any private residences because it's not safe for anyone. Halsey is a singer and songwriter who gained attention from her self-released music on social media around 2014. She then released her debut studio album Badlands in 2015, and it wasn't long before Halsey was a certified pop star. Her singles and albums continue to top the charts, and just last year, Billboard reported that Halsey has sold over 1 million albums and been streamed over 6 billion times in the US alone. While less than a decade ago, Halsey was just an unknown teen uploading her music online, these days she's amassed herself an estimated net worth of about $20 million, enough to drop over $10 million on a mansion. Aside from that recording studio, her sprawling compound boasts a number of structures, including the massive main home, a guest house, pool house, meditation house, koi pond, enchanted gardens, and much more. Hey everyone, I'm Kara the Vampire Slayer, here for you with another exclusive house tour on Famous Entertainment. While we reported on Halsey's homes back in the day, it was time for an update because her new Calabasas place is unlike any of her former homes. If you haven't already, be sure to subscribe and ring that bell for notifications because we post brand new videos daily. As always, you can follow me on Instagram to chat, and now let's get into this video. With the arrival of her first child, Halsey sought out to expand her living situation earlier this year, paying about $10.2 million to fellow singer and former One Direction member Liam Payne for the property. Apparently, Liam was looking to offload the home since 2019, first listing it at $12.9 million and as a luxury rental for $40K per month. It seems that Halsey took the compound off his hands at a discount, maybe because it was haunted. Yes, you heard me correctly. Liam once claimed the gorgeous abode was haunted by Alan Perwin, the late aerial film operator who actually built the place back in 1991. Not only did Liam state he experienced lights and taps going on and off in the middle of the night, but a neighbor told him there was a ghost called Alan in the house right when they moved in. Way to scare someone off.
Turns out, she said the guy's name's Alan. The guy who used to live there was the helicopter pilot for the shots that you see in Jurassic Park where there's a helicopter.
Either way, all of the amazing features in this mansion are sure to distract Halsey from any spirits. And at over 9,650 square feet, there's plenty of room for everyone. Halsey's pad is located on 4.75 acres of land up in the Santa Monica Mountains between two posh neighborhoods, Calabasas and Malibu. Of course, the massive property is private and gated with a guardhouse for extra security and situated at the end of a private lane surrounded by trees. Driveway leads over a stone and wooden bridge up to the front of the Spanish-style main residence, which offers 5 bedrooms and 8 bathrooms. While the interior features of Halsey's house are amazing, the outside boasts peaceful spaces like a meditation house you could even treat as a massage area with picturesque view. But more on the outdoor features in just a sec. The main house has large wooden doors at the entryway, and this space has double height ceilings, rich hardwood floors, and matching ceilings overhead. To one side, there's a great room with an old world chandelier, stone fireplace, and detailed doors with windows. Another family room near the kitchen has upper level balconies overlooking the space with soaring ceilings, a TV, and more. The kitchen is grand like the rest of the mansion, comprised of luxe wood frames, tiled flooring, and a large island. Another fun feature here is the built-in aquarium. One of the most impressive spaces in Halsey's home has got to be the study or library. This room is fully wood paneled aside from the fireplace and has a lower level seating area furnished with built-in bookshelves, a TV, and piano. The upper level gallery in the library boasts more space for books as well as another grand chandelier. To say this room is classy is an understatement. Other main floor living spaces include a formal dining room where Halsey can entertain friends and family, where there's yet another fireplace and glass doors doors that offer a direct view of the outdoor waterfall. Moving upstairs, the bedrooms are equally luxurious as the rest of Halsey's home, but her master suite is of course the best of all. Her relaxing retreat features more wood-beamed ceilings, a sitting area, walk-out balcony, and epic ensuite bath. With double vanities, a soaking tub, and separate tiled shower, the bathroom has a unique design as well to match the rest of the mansion. The private recording studio on the property is spacious, soundproofed, and ready for Halsey to start creating, and there are other amenities for when the star would rather play instead of work. A downstairs level of the mansion features spacious games room with billiards table, arcade games, and more. And if that's not Halsey's thing, there's also a gorgeous wine cellar and elsewhere, a movie theater with leather seating. The grounds of Halsey's estate have got to be one of the selling points, is moving outside, everything is landscaped perfectly. Out back, there are multiple terraces. One right off of the mansion is covered and offers a lounge with fire pit, seating, outdoor fireplace, and TV with a barbecue station and dining table nearby. But if Halsey is seeking some quiet time, the property has a sanctuary area too. The grounds are full of gardens, trees, waterfalls, and there's even a rock-lined creek. Choose to unwind in the secret corner of the yard, boasting a hammock in the trees, or at the meditation building located next to the koi pond. If all of that isn't enough for you, bonus outbuildings include two guest houses and a fitness pavilion equipped with plenty of exercise machines. We can't miss the deluxe-sized swimming pool and spa either, which rounds out the property and looks too inviting for Halsey not to spend some time at. According to records, Halsey also sold her former home in the Beechwood Canyon area of Los Angeles last year for over $2.3 million and continues to own a home she purchased in Sherman Oak. In 2019, the singer shelled out $2.4 million for a mid-century style residence in Sherman Oaks, a neighborhood in LA that's slightly more suburban, but gaining popularity among celebrities. While this home has got nothing on her new mansion, it was still a fresh and modern estate designed by famed mid-century architect Richard Dorman in 1959. Unique from the surrounding, ordinary-looking homes, Halsey's residence was post and beam style with features like light terrazzo floors and walls of glass trimmed in black metal. Super private and tucked away from the main street, Halsey's Sherman Oaks hideaway spanned about 2,200 square feet of space with 4 beds and 2.5 baths. While the home was renovated and updated over the years, the original design of the place was preserved. The single-level residence offered up an open floor plan for a laid-back California vibe, complete with full walls of glass throughout. There was a combination living-dining room with giant masonry fireplace, as well as a much cozier den to hang out in, and elsewhere an office. The eat-in, galley-style kitchen was minimalistic, but had been updated with designer appliances, a wine fridge, and sparkling white countertops. Both guest rooms opened right up to the yard via glass sliders, just like the much more spacious master suite. Halsey's ensuite bath here was also roomy, featuring dual vanities and another door to the yard. It seems one benefit of a single-level home like this is easy access to the ground. Moving to the exterior of Halsey's former home, there was a large free-form swimming pool, elegant patio, and grassy lawn space. It may not be as cool as her new Calabasas crib, but there was still enough space for a pool party, that's for sure. After taking a look at Halsey's new family home, or mansion that is, as well as her other piece of property in Sherman Oaks, I think that concludes this house tour. I gotta say, since the last time we saw the singer's properties, she's seriously upgraded her real estate portfolio with the addition of her current mansion. Her other mid-century bungalow isn't even in the same league as her new compound. Out of all the luxury amenities at Halsey's current mansion, did you have a favorite? I mean, there was a deluxe pool, a fitness building, a recording studio, and even smaller add-ons like the aquarium in the kitchen. I love the whole vibe of her home with all of the wood accents, grand chandeliers, and classic look. Also, who could forget that library? I can only dream of having a space even half as impressive to store all my books one day. If you had to choose, would you rather have a games room or the movie theater in Halsey's mansion? I would definitely pick the movie theater. Be sure to tell me all your thoughts on Halsey's homes in the comments down below. Thanks for watching, don't forget to follow me on Instagram, and I'll see you all next time. Bye!